Now to a story about a high-profile and unusual CEO whose own philosophy and unique life experience has influenced the way things operate day-to-day inside the company. Economics correspondent Paul Solman has the story, part of our ongoing reporting, Making Sense, which airs every Thursday on the NewsHour.
Aetna Insurance, number 57 on the Fortune 500, surprised corporate America recently when it hiked its minimum wage to $16 an hour. It was a quirky move by a quirky CEO, Mark Bertolini, motorcycle enthusiast, former hippie, and two-time college dropout who aced the GMAT exam on a lark, which led to a Cornell MBA and a career in health insurance. This CEO manages by walking around, slowly and mindfully, actually practicing walking meditation and attentively listening to his employees.
This income inequality issue was rattling around in my head. I mean, I came from a family that was not, you know, we sometimes didn't have insurance. My dad worked half time. My mother was a part-time nurse. I've been pushing the team on it, but I was getting this sort of, you know, we're running a company, you know, this is a, we're, you know, a capitalist enterprise, we're a commercial enterprise.
Did they know that you were a hippie in the
70s? Well, kind of. We're not the first company to really make this kind of investment. I mean, Patagonia, there's a book out about it, right? Let my people go surfing, right?
And yeah, a hippie company, yes.
Well, it's not being a hippie, it's being a good person. I mean, you know, what have we forgotten about the 70s that we all of a sudden as business people come into the community and say, well, that was really cool back then, but now I'm an adult? I actually showed people once when we were talking about change, I said to them, if you think change is bad, look at your high school picture. And I put mine up on the stage and everyone went, oh my God. so they got a glimpse. I mean, I didn't talk about all of it. I mean, you know, there are things that you don't talk about in polite company. But
so aren't they a little skeptical of you?
I don't think people are skeptical. I think people appreciate the authenticity, actually. I think people are looking for authentic leaders these days. And being yourself, I mean, you know, I put this tie on for you today, by the way. So
I appreciate it.
I don't wear ties to work, and I don't shave.
As his Twitter feed suggests, Bertolini, as CEO of a major healthcare company, isn't exactly beloved of all his employees. But he answers them, as he answers unhappy customers.
I'm not the most loved person on the planet. People assume they understand who I am by what I do.
In fact, a near-death experience in 2004 led Bertolini to make big changes in his personal life and at the company.
I broke my neck skiing and detached the nerve root from my arm that connected it to my spinal cord. And so it's sort of like the troubled sibling of the body. It, you know, it doesn't operate as well as it should.
And almost died, right?
They gave me last rites in the helicopter on the way to the hospital. When I had that accident, I couldn't engage in my physical activity the way I had before. And I started engaging in yoga as a physical practice, but very quickly found out there was something broader to it and that it was actually helpful for my pain. And started getting into meditation, started to study the Upanishads and the Bhagavad Gita and a lot of the scriptures associated with yoga, the Yoga Sutras. And very quickly came to this conclusion that this had a huge impact on my ability to lead, but more importantly, the ability to control my sympathetic nervous system, which had a direct tie to the pain in my arm.
So your arm would be hurting all the time?
My arm hurts all the time now. It hurts right now. It never stops hurting. But it's the level of pain that is associated with it is dependent on how I manage my sympathetic nervous system. So I came to work one day and I said, you know, I think we should do meditation and yoga at work. And everybody went, oh, you know, the eye roll, right? And it's because the CEO does yoga and meditation, we all got to do yoga and meditation.
And now bring your focus to the center of your chest. As you inhale, imagining the breath comes from the center of your chest and expands outward.
So Bertolini ordered a study to see if meditation and yoga would dampen the stress levels of 239 employee volunteers.
And we saw dramatic drops, 50% drops in cortisol levels and heart rate variability. We saw a $3,000 reduction in their healthcare costs through the next year. We saw 69 more minutes of productivity a month.
And employee testimonials were revealing.
My marriage has been saved. My children were wild. I've engaged them in this practice. My household is much more quiet. We had a person who was going to kill themselves, and you know, I decided not to do it. People lost weight. I mean, it was just like, oh my gosh, if you have a program that costs us $190,000 to do, could save just one life, wouldn't that be worth it?
By now, more than 13,000 employees out of a total of 49,000 have taken part. The most recent free 10-week yoga session at Aetna's Hartford headquarters was oversubscribed within hours.
The intention is just to feel or sense the body, to notice sensations.
While online mindfulness classes have also proven popular.
Just practicing letting be.
There are weight loss programs.
I've had these 10 extra pounds that I just can't get rid of.
There are health screenings. All hold the promise of paying off for workers and company alike.
The first year after we did the program, our healthcare costs actually dropped 7.5% as a company. And I have to think a part of our success since then as a company and how well we've done as an organization and that we're growing, we've been growing now for 3 consecutive years, is part of that.
Let's see how the company does now that he's taking it in a very non-traditional direction. This is economics correspondent Paul Solman reporting from Boston, as mindfully as I can manage, for the PBS NewsHour.